गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, दिस साइड सिद्धार्थ कोस्टिक, आई वेलकम यू ऑल। इन टुडेज सेशन वी विल सॉल्व प्रोजेक्ट एलएलएम प्रॉब्लम 7 यूजिंग मैटलैब। द क्वेश्चन स्टेट्स दैट बाय लिस्टिंग द फर्स्ट सिक्स प्राइम नंबर्स 2 3 5 7 11 एंड 13 वी कैन सी द सिक्स्थ प्राइम इज 13। नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द प्राइम नंबर व्हिच इज लोकेटेड एट द नंबर 10001। ओके, सो I have written a MATLAB code for you. Let me first check whether a code is working good or not. Then I will explain you that how the code is working. So to do that, I will copy this using Control C. Now I will Control V here. Now I will put 6 here. So the sixth prime is 13, which is given in our question. Now we have to find out the prime number which is located at the location 10001. So I will click the up arrow in the keyboard and I will put here 10001. It will take some time to calculate the prime number which is located at the 10001 position. So the answer is 1,4,743. So this is the official website of Project ILab. I have already solved the question and have given the answer. The answer is 1,4,743. So our code is working good. Now let me explain you that how the code is working. So to do that, first I will clear all of the variables from the workspace. I will put CLC here. I will exclude this percentage sign. Save it and I will put tilde symbol here. I will also put a breakpoint here to debug the code. Debugging the code helps in understanding the code step by step. So I will run this code. I have defined 4 variables here. I will explain you what this variable does and how I am using these variables. So the first variable is n, which is equal to 6, or you can say the prime number which is located at the 6th position. Okay, here I have defined a garbage variable prime numbers equal to 0, another variable a equal to 0, and another variable num is equal to 1. Now in this line I am checking whether the value of variable a is less than equal to n or not. If the condition satisfies, this green command or this green arrow will come to the next line. So initially a is less than equal to 6, the condition satisfies, the green arrow will come to the next line. Okay, now the prime, here we are calculating prime numbers equal to primes of n. Now to explain what this does, let me quit this debugging and explain you what this number does. So primes, before that, prime number, let me explain you what is a prime number. Prime number is a number which is a natural number which is divisible by only itself. Okay, for example, like a number 4 is divisible by 1, is divisible by 2, and is divisible by 4 is not a prime number. A number which is only divisible by itself or 1 is a prime number. Or you can say prime number is a natural number which is greater than 1 and is divisible by itself. Okay, so 2 3, so here this function is giving the number of prime numbers which is equal to or less than to this number 4 2 3 5 2 3 5. In case of 6, 2 3 5. In case of 7, 2 3 5 7. The next prime number is 11, so I will directly put 11. Okay, 10, it is giving till the 7, because 10 is not a prime number, 9 is also not a prime number, and 8 is also not a prime number. Okay, so put CLC. Let me run this. So we have 4 variables, n, prime nums, a, and num. Initially the condition satisfies. We'll come to the next line. Here we are calculating the primes of the nums, giving that vector or variable to the prime nums. Initially it is 0, so as num is equal to 1, the primes will be 0, so this will be an empty vector. Now in this line I am calculating the length of this vector. So initially it is empty vector, so a will be equal to 0, is already a 0 actually. Now num, I am adding plus 1 to the num number or the variable num. Now num is equal to 2, you can check num is 2. Condition satisfied, 0 is less than 6. 0, 2, if the number is 2, the prime number will be 2. The length of this will be 1, a is equal to 1, and num is updated to the 3. Now, if num is 3, the primes will be 2 and 3. Here you can see the length will be 2 and 3 because it has 2 elements, 2 and 3. The length will be 2. Initially it is 1, now it will be 2. Okay. Now num is updated to the 4. If the num is 4, we will have only 2 primes, 2 and 3, because 4 is not a prime number. Is gonna be 2, num is updated to the 5. A 2 is less than 6, condition is still satisfies. Now 2, 3, 5, we have 3 primes, A will be updated to the 3. You see it is 3. Now num is updated to the 6. 7, 2, 3, 5, and 7. A will be equal to the 4. You can check. Now A is 4, num is updated to the 8, because 8 is not a prime number, 9 is not a prime number, 10 is not a prime number, now 11. 11 is a prime number, it is added to the prime numbers vector. A is updated to the 5, you can see our num is 12. 12 is not a prime number. Now 13. 13 is a prime number. So here 13 is added to this vector. Now it has 6 elements. Now A will be equal to the 6. Now num is updated to the 14, which doesn't matter actually, because now A is not less than n, because A is 6 and n is also 6. So the condition does not satisfy and the loop will break. Can see loop has completed. Let's go to the next line. Now in this line I am calculating the maximum number available in the vector prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, and 13. Maximum number is 30, so the answer will be 30. Now okay. So similarly you can check for higher numbers, but it will take less time, so we will not do it here. Okay. Thank you for watching this video. We'll see you in the upcoming videos. Thank you.